Hello.
Yeah.
Alright. Okay, let's wait till the stream changes over to this and we'll see if we can be heard.
Yeah, the thing is, I am hearing music, but
I can,
so
I can hear,
bloody
I can
low.
Hear. No, I can hear the stream. Hello. I can hear the voices.
Alright.
I can hear the voices inside my head.
Okay. Then
I
believe.
I can hear myself.
Yep. Alright, so.
The problem is, but the thing
just
is,
clearing
I
chat.
I still hear myself pretty low. I still hear myself quite low.
Get low, get low, get low.
To the window.
This is the same settings we had last time, so it should be working fine.
Wait, let me see if it's just me.
No, I can hear it, it's fine.
That's just him. Anyway, hello to those viewers that are watching. If some of you are wondering,
but it's still also kind of low at the same time.
I can't do anything. You're yelling in my ear right now. It's not from my settings. You're set to maximum.
On Discord?
Yes, on Discord and on OBS.
I'm listening. I'm hearing everyone fine in the stream.
No, I mean, it's fine, but it's a little bit low. Like, compared to a lot of other videos you hear, it's quite low.
Well, yeah, I mean,
that's not supposed to happen, though.
Error 404, a team of highly expert monkeys has been dispatched on the scene.
I mean, you don't want people who are actually going to try watching this stream to put the volume so high up that when they try to play they forget about it. They try to play something else and suddenly their ears are bleeding.
I can't do anything about it.
Must be some problem with the setting.
The settings are the same that we had
OBS
for.
Is just shit.
OBS is one of the best streaming softwares.
I'm hearing it fine. No, it's not even low for me. I'm hearing it fine. Like, it's the same volume as I hear you guys. Right now.
Could just be from your end, dude. Okay, back to the introduction. For those of you wondering, where is Zombie Survival? #1. We had originally streamed that on Twitch. Unfortunately, that recording is lost. We have no way of getting it back. I'm really sorry about that, but that's all we got. For those that want a basic recap of what happened, they met in a subway when the outbreak broke out. They quickly went over to Mattis's hideaway and got all their weapons, which they currently have, except for the military-grade items which they found on their journey. Last time, we had reached Maine, and you were tasked with a job of blowing up a compound filled with ex-survivors that were in Maine and are threatening to destroy it. Meanwhile, back at camp...
Was it 40 or 20?
What?
In the actual, how many do you have to, you know?
Unspecified.
Yeah, but the enemies were like 60, I think, if I remember correctly.
There were like 10 cars, so.
You specified the enemies, because I know you said there were 40 people, and we have 40 allies, but an X amount of enemies, but whatever.
No, enemies were 60.
60, okay.
Yeah, we were definitely outnumbered.
But we had the advantage because stealth and whatnot.
Yeah, they have the number advantage, though, that's all.
Yeah.
Moving on.
Anyway, moving on. Meanwhile, back at camp, you have Adrian and someone's at the door.
And someone's
well,
at
right
the door
back
of the camp.
After these messages.
Mattis, kill the elevator.
I am back. Sorry about that. Grazie, ma. Okay, so. Where was I? So. Back at camp, you guys do not know what's going on unless you have stream sniped, which I hope you did not.
Nope. I can't play stream, remember? My internet is crap.
You can watch the playback.
Yeah. I need to take 2 hours of my day and the exams are on the way,
yeah.
So rip.
True. Anyway, back on topic. So, we shall start back at camp for today. So, Adrian, if you please.
Nobody streams
plus.
Aha, I'm on the stream, but I put this on.
Hello. Okay, you can hear me?
Yeah, by the way, the delay isn't very bad on the stream.
Mm, great.
It's like 4 seconds.
That's pretty good. Alright, so you are at the camp. You do remember what happened last time, or shall I repeat?
Recap would be nice. It's been a while since we played.
Okay, so you had got a horde pass through during the night. You got lucky.
Mm-hmm.
And because of the fire that randomly spontaneously combusted. And it's morning. You start looking around. Nothing's damaged much. There's something glinting towards the east side of the perimeter.
That's right. I went to get it. I remember now.
Do you remember what it was?
Not really.
It was a broken flashlight glass. Someone from the inside is sabotaging.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Alright. Okay, so that's basically, I just wanted to give you a quick recap about what happened since the other is gone.
Yeah.
No. Back to the other chat.
Or shouldn't.
Or shouldn't, no. Yeah. Anyways. Hello? Okay. And this is why we don't have nice things. Also, with us today, we have Garrett, who is just going to be a silent spectator. Okay.
He should not be silent. He should commentate every now and again.
Yes. I am also going to take off the screen capture for a bit because someone has sent me a message via Discord. Give me a minute. Alright. So, you're in main, and it's around midnight. Okay, so it's around midnight. Your current task is to quickly go and try and get rid of the enforcers that want to take main down. Yeah, you know, your time to speak is now.
Yeah.
So we're gonna take down those fucks again that we don't like because they're mean to our friends-ish friends.
Zach's my glad.
For fuck's sake.
Is that the idealist from us too?
Random spontaneous sound appears.
Hello? That was completely weird. I don't know how I died. Sorry about that.
That's fine.
I was saying, isn't the whole raid thing tomorrow?
No, you're going during the night.
So it's tonight?
Yes.
Alright, where the hell's Faresh?
It isn't that far off from you. It's like a 2-hour walk. I am currently trying to increase the sound on stream, because I had another complaint that the sound quality was low. I'm trying to add some gain to it. Maybe it can be heard better. So, let's see.
So
if
it wasn't me going insane.
The thing is, one saying is fine, the other isn't. What's going on? I do not know.
Yeah.
Filters, gain. Okay.
Only Adrian is actually saying it's fine. Then there are me and someone else is saying it's not.
Okay, so I tried to fix it. Let's see if this has worked. Again, switching off screen. A minute. Okay, see you. Okay, I'll try to increase the gain. Shit, I accidentally showed who I was talking to. Anyways, I shall try to quickly fuck with the gain again slightly. Oh shit, I'm retarded. Yep.
Same.
Properties.
For anyone who wishes to join Mullet Studios, that is a requirement.
What?
You need to be retarded.
Kill yourself.
Same.
Alright, so, okay, that should make you guys yell, hopefully not a lot.
Oh, that's better.
I was about to yell into my microphone, but then I realized Mattis has sensitive ears.
Yep.
Well, you guys are kind of low for me right now, so it's not that bad. Plus, it's more for squeaking noises rather than anything.
So I can freely do this then, right?
Yep.
Please don't.
I listened to the stream a little bit. It's a lot better.
Okay. I had to increase a filter and get the gain up to 30 decibels.
Alright.
Okay, so back to the campaign.
Reality.
You are outside main. The guys are waiting for you. They have a large, like, school bus which you're going to go and try and take out the camp with.
We're going on a trip to go kill some fucking dicks.
Zach, now you're very low.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Same.
I don't know what to do about that. I do not know what to do.
Bring some children.
Wait, Max, on Discord, is everyone on highest?
Is anyone what?
Is everyone on highest volume for you?
Yes.
You set them on highest, I mean, like, on Discord.
Am I better now or no?
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, good. Anyway, where's Faresh?
Faresh, as I said, is a one-hour travel away.
He's gone already.
Oh.
Faresh.
Oh, fuck, I thought you meant Faresh the place.
No, as in, like, there's a guy who's called Faresh the Doctor.
I forgot.
Isn't Faresh the place in another asleep. Campaign?
Yes, I...
That's in another campaign, yes.
Shut up! I mix it up, okay? Okay, so...
Well, good to know, in our other current pain, Faresh is 1 hour away.
Faresh is currently with his wife and two children asleep.
What the hell? He's supposed to be part of this.
He is part of the rebellion, but he can't be seen. He's seen as one of the higher figures, aka he's currently being watched.
How many people are there?
In the
We have 40 men, right?
You have around 40 men, yes.
We have 40 men. I'm gonna walk up and is there like a figure of a 40 there or no?
Well, there's the old guy, Eduardo.
Okay, I'm gonna walk up to Eduardo and be like, is this our little army that we have placed here?
Eduardo is the guy that's against the fighting.
Why is he standing outside
of the village you're currently in.
No, as in like, so they're waiting for us outside.
Okay, the people waiting for you, sorry. Sure, the driver's there, he's like a very redneck kind of guy, he's got a fishnet hat on, and his name's Gabe.
Okay.
His name's Gabe.
Alright.
I'm Gabe!
And I'm supposed to know this from my telepathy powers. I'm gonna walk up to him and be like, is this our fellow little... Are these all our soldiers?
Afraid so. He just starts smoking a cigarette.
I'm gonna look at all the people who are in the bus.
Alright. There are like a couple of kids along with some adults. One of them has like a splinter on his leg. The other doesn't have an arm. It's a fuck fest.
I'm gonna turn to Gabe and be like, no. Well, fine, he can do that. I'm gonna turn to Gabe and be like, first that these men were trained.
The ones with the broken limbs or?
Oh, that them.
Motherfucker.
Are you getting in or are we going without you? I am. Name's Gabe.
Do you know what you're doing, at least?
Yep. 5 years in the Marines.
Dang. Nice. Alright.
Was off the coast before I got fucked over by the apocalypse.
Yeah, look on the bright side. You had a nice view while all the zombies were eating corpses around you.
Sure.
Yeah, I'm gonna climb in. I'm gonna get in the van.
You guys clamber into
some candy.
Into the bus, by the way, it's not the van.
But before I get on the bus, actually, I'm going to go back to the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
And back to that little girl.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, who's coming with us again? Everyone's coming with us. Where's Hans?
Hans has fucked off. He's actually already bought a home by giving toilet paper.
I want to go find Hans real quick.
Okay, you give me a D6.
Fuck off.
You're like, Hans, where are you, my lover? And the guy just is pissed drunk, coming out of the bar, is like, fuck off!
Come on.
Okay.
Yeah, so that turned out great.
Same. Right.
Can I ask around for Hans instead of just yelling around like an idiot?
That was your one attempt. Come on.
Hans is gone. He's dead. He's married. Same thing.
He's dead and married. Nice.
He's dead and married.
What's the difference?
Where the hell's Farash? Where's Farash's house? I have to know that much at least.
It's next to the hospital.
I'm going to knock.
Okay, loud knock or small knock?
Well, I'm not gonna bang his door down, but I'm gonna wake him up enough so they notice.
Give me a D6.
Give me a D6 to see. Oh, that's a D20, sorry. Can I take that?
I'm gonna let that slide. Yeah, sure.
Sorry, I have... So, are we using D6s? So, I changed the command.
But that's fine. I'll let this one time slide. You knock gracefully, yet with some force. Also, while this happens, you flip your hair, which gracefully shimmers in the moonlit sky, and no one's there to see it. Feel bad now.
No, there's Mathis behind me.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you whip Mathis in the face.
Leave me out of his role.
Alright. I'm waiting outside the door.
You hear clambering in the inside, and Farash come out. He's like, why are you still here? You should have gone to do the bombs already.
Keep it down. We don't want everyone to know what we're doing. Anyway, I need someone to look after the girl while I'm gone.
It is not my problem. I have my own kids.
I'll owe you the favor.
You already owe
I'm
me more
than
that. I'm
going you up instead.
Do I owe
we'll
him
owe him more than that.
He's giving
okay,
you
we'll
free.
Just...
He's giving you free healthcare to who he thinks is your daughter.
I am also helping him incite a rebellion secretly.
Which could get us killed. The daughter, it couldn't get us killed. This is not a life for a life.
And we also walked in peacefully.
For fuck's sake, he like puts on his coat. He's like in bunny slippers. He's going out.
Okay.
I swear to Christ, you're gonna owe me more than one for this. And he takes his smoking pipe and goes next to the child.
You don't have to like stay next to her. You could take her indoors or something, but it's up to you.
No, you fucking tell me. He just pulls the stretcher into his
room. It's not my fault. He's an idiot.
I'm not gonna say that, but same.
No, I just whispered to you. It's not our fault.
Gabe comes
idiot.
Up from behind you. Are we gonna go? Or are we gonna wait for another day?
Another day.
We'll be there in a bit. Just get back on the bus.
Ugh.
All right. Cheers, Farash. I appreciate it. I'm gonna walk up behind Gabe.
He closes his door and just, like, yeah.
Yep, yeah, I am going to walk off onto the bus to my death.
I hope you pack the fucking pair of pants because this shit's about to go down. Gabe turns on the bus. And
Gabe, I think most of us have forgotten what clean underwear is.
What is underwear?
I was pulling my pants down when I took a shit.
What is underwear?
What is underwear, baby? Don't
Shut
hurt
up.
Me.
Baby, don't shit me.
You go through the back exit of main, and you're slowly making your way over there. You can see a couple of zombies.
Just to clarify
the
that
roads,
these are right in my mind. Just to clarify the plan in my mind. I am staying with one of the groups that are... So it's going to work. We're going to split into teams of 10. We're all gonna stealthily surround the area, mm-hmm. and then Mathis and Steven are gonna go plant the bombs.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You can have an advantage because...
Actually, you know, can I yell, bitches be damned?
If you want to get killed, go ahead.
Oh, can I silently yell, bitches be damned?
Heck yeah.
Sure, give me a d6.
This is like on the road, he's just silently gonna try yell this.
Nice. You semi-manage, your voice cracks in the middle, so you're like, bitches be damned!
Yeah, boy, even bitches better. That's what I wanted, actually. Yeah, boy.
Okay.
So we're on the road again.
Copyright strikes incoming.
Right. My voice is that good.
Yes, yes. Okay, so you start looking around, as I said before. There are zombies on the sidewalks eating animals, and you can see like a couple of rabid animals again, which have been infected, and they are completely feral. In front of the bus, a feral reindeer does jump out and is instantly crushed underneath the bus. You can hear the sound of his bone crunch underneath the wheels.
Roadkill. This is fictional America, right?
Yes.
No shit, it's fictional America. If it was real America, then I mean...
Is it? Where's the most common place to run over deer? Canada or
everywhere.
America?
Canada, actually.
Well, it's mainly Canada, isn't it?
Shut
up. Oh yeah, definitely fucking Malta.
Oh, God. Okay, so...
It was only yesterday I ran over a deer, you know. Because I drive.
XDDDD.
Why'd you kill your old grandma? She was such a deer.
You should feel bad right around now.
A pain in the antlers.
You feel your sins crawling up your back.
And anyway, this is why I don't get more subscribers. This is why! And Kawaii bought this down. Fuck!
Use the dice rolling thing. Or do I have to send the link again?
Yep.
Can you guys do what I'm doing and just favorite it on your, like, top bar?
I want to, but I keep forgetting.
Do it now!
Do it, pussy! Anyway. So. You eventually, like, pull up and there's this, like, large supermarket where Gabe tells you they're all waiting to attack, obviously. This is like their
main... So everyone's formed and this is like the last group of 10?
No, this is, you're currently just outside the supermarket and you're like, this is where all the fuckers are.
And we're still, there's still all 40 of us here.
Yes.
Right? I'm gonna be like, alright Gabe, who are the other three most competent people in this bus?
Me, the one with the one arm?
Not including you.
He's probably gonna fight.
The one
as
with
well.
One arm.
Alright.
I'm willing to fight if you let me.
No, of course, yo, fuck it, you're gonna come fight. Right. Every single man for that.
He like steps out of the vehicle and realizes he has a pig leg.
Oh.
So it's me, the guy with one arm, and old Jim over there. There's like a really rugged, very bossed old man, but he looked like he can lift the boss with one arm.
Damn, alright.
Sweet, he's swole. Alright, does everyone know what the plan is?
We're gonna run in there, guns blazing.
No, that's not the plan. Does everyone know the actual plan?
Then no. Yeah, yeah.
No!
Alright, good.
Fuck off.
Same, love you.
Love you also.
And he's gone. Rest in peace, Zach. He was never heard from again.
And this is why we have the elevator music.
Yeah.
Yay.
Live stream, everybody.
Only the liveliest.
Only the liveliest of all streams.
Hello?
There he is.
There you go.
That's weird. Let me just disconnect and reconnect real quick. Sorry, guys.
Here's down.
I say it again. Elevator music.
There we go. That should be better now. I don't know why it's not working. All right. Yeah, so essentially, I'm going to get, like, everyone to split up into, like, teams of 10. Like, the three guys you pointed out will take each group of 10, stay around the signs. And when the bombs go up, we all attack. I want to stay with Gabe and his group.
Okay.
And I'll take Jeffrey with me.
Okay. Mathis, who do you wish to stay for? Stay with, I mean.
Mathis is going in the middle.
I'm going in the middle.
He's doing the bombs, remember?
Yep.
Okay.
Can see weather.
Can my group and Gabe go on the northern side of the supermarket? Can we take that position?
Sure.
Okay, so we'll just take that position and move out stealthily and surround the place.
Okay. Give me a D6, please.
Okie dokie. Where's Mattis? What are you doing? How are you going to infiltrate?
That is actually a good question. Around the back?
Well, pretty much everyone is. If you want to split up with one of the groups and then move out from there.
Yeah, well, that's probably one of the best ideas.
Alright, first we'll roll this D6 to see if stuff happens.
Okay.
Rip. We failed.
You're as stealthy as a walrus on ice.
Okay, so as soon as you put down the packet of C4 and you start walking back, you set off a tripwire which is connected to tin cans, which makes a lot of noise. Yeah, that is not good. They're coming from the... They are rushing through the doors as we speak, looking at you, and they can see you, your group, and Mattis's group.
Oh, okay.
In a nutshell, you're either going to have to risk it and see if you take some damage by blowing it up now, or start running and then blow it up, but risk the chance of having to fight them all.
What are we doing? Sorry, my mom came in the room.
Okay, so, you have a choice. You're like a few meters away from the blast, but it can still hit you with shrapnel. You can...
I've heard nothing from since I roll, so give me everything.
Jesus fucking Christ. Okay, for the 15th fucking time, you put the bomb down, and you started walking away.
I don't have the bombs.
Everyone has a piece of the bomb.
We've placed the bombs, you set off a tripwire, they're coming for us. We can either set it off now and risk taking damage, or we can run, set it off, but risk fighting them all.
Okay, this is not how I planned out before, but alright.
The dice tell the story, good lad. The dice tell the story.
Yes, but I never had an explosive on me, but I'll just go over that.
You didn't, your group did.
No, the point was you two were the only ones who had the bombs. That was the plan. Well, we just stayed there to protect you in case you fucked up.
No, you had to do four corners.
Exactly, they do all four corners. No. There's no way you can get, like, 10 people to like, set four charges without them being noticed. That's impossible.
That's what you tried
to
do.
Oh, we did. Exactly, and we didn't manage.
No, the point was that only Mattis and Steven were supposed to get in there. And if they messed up, then we'd just open fire.
No, those were from your men that were going to be put in the line of fire. Then there were going to be two NPCs that plant the rest.
Oh, fuck it. That was a horrible miscommunication. We were forming the plan then.
Yeah. Apparently so.
So our options are hurt ourselves or fight everyone.
Yeah. Risk to fight everyone, yeah.
I would vote to blow it up.
Why not?
Give me a D6 to see if you get hit by shrapnel.
I got hit by shrapnel. RIP. I'm curious.
I'm good.
I'm curious, actually. I want to check something.
You get your foot foot stuck on the tripwire, and when you set it off, you do end up slightly grazing the right side of your leg. But in the process, you do manage to collapse it on all the people inside, except for. I'm not gonna be an asshole, so I'll do this. Come on. All right, four people.
Okay. Well, since the jig is up, I'm just gonna be open fire. Open fire.
Fire
at will.
The survivors start opening fire on everyone, and it is a complete bloodbath as they turn into just Swiss cheese.
Okay.
Gabe, with his peg leg, you can see it like slowly gyrate as he's shooting. He gives you his other hand, which he's not shooting with, and pulls you up quickly. And it's like, get to the fucking bus, we've made too much noise.
Alright, I'll do that.
As you are quickly, in your case, limping, and also in his case, kind of limping, since he has a peg leg.
I've seen him, it's 5 years, I've seen him used to it. Yeah, he's used to it at least.
But he's not as fast as a normal person, but still. Everyone quickly clambers back on the bus, and you can see the large horde has now come and is now facing the bus.
Ooh. Who is in the driver's seat?
Gabe, currently.
What's the turn called? K-turn! Is it K-turn?
I think you mean U-turn.
No, U-turn takes too long. I'm talking about... Is it the one that goes, like, backwards?
Rabbit hard! Right.
Three-point turn?
No, wait. A three-point turn, yeah, that's it.
Okay, so you're like, three-point turn! He quickly starts, like, shifting the gears, and... Let's see if he manages.
What the hell's a K-point turn, actually, now that I think about it? And it never rolls.
Nope, still don't roll. Okay. I'm gonna do it via... Okay, never mind. She's back.
Oh, two. That's fun. Okay.
Yeah, this is very bad.
To do the turn, the gear stick snaps off.
The bus is fine, but a zombie does manage to grab him and is currently throttling him.
Am I just sitting next to him?
Yes.
Shoot him in the face. Well, not Gabe, the zombie throttling him.
Give me a d20, please.
Oh, that's a shame.
Alright, I could try to do a collateral, but no. Oh, come on.
Okay, can I just smack the dome in the head with the butt of my gun?
D20 again, please.
There we go. Yep.
You hit it square in the face, making it collapse, and instantly getting crushed by the tire. You're on your way back to camp. The horde is still behind you.
No, don't go back to camp. Go in the opposite direction. Don't lead the horde towards camp.
You can't go in the opposite direction. That's the direction where the horde is.
Okay, not the complete opposite direction. Take a left instead when we have to go right.
Okay, there's an abandoned estate over there. We can try and hide an apartment while the horde goes through.
Sure, fuck it, go.
He starts flooring it, so he tries to get some distance between you and the horde. You can see that he has a very large gash in his arm. It's not a bite.
It's a bite.
It is not a bite. It's just
a gash. He's good. Okay. We're fine. Protagonist immunity. Wink, wink.
No, we're not even immune. That's the sad part.
Rip. Oh well.
He's just slightly hurt. You can see him clutching at it. It is hurting like a bitch, but it is not infected.
Okay.
I pee on it.
He pulls up to this, like, apartment complex, which is, like, in a part of the suburbs. It's not that like bad overall and this complete and utter ruins. You can try and clamber inside, but if the horde ends up going into the building, you're pretty much dead.
Same.
One guy on the roof.
Okay, you get all the men, none of them died, so that's another 40 men. All clambering up these stairs quickly.
Oh, Jesus.
Up the stairs quickly. Halfway up, the stairway breaks and 20 of them fall to their death. Yeah.
At least let them roll for it, poor fellas.
They're all dead.
Fine.
Thank you.
Yeah, two survive. Two survive. The fall.
We are 40 men and only 20 died.
Yeah, two of the 20 men that fall die. Survive.
The only two of the 20 men die. You see how bad that is?
You've lost three souls.
So that means we only have 22 people left.
You can also see the horde, because of the sound of the stairwell breaking, are actually coming into the building.
But how are they gonna get up? The stairs are broken.
Yeah, that's the good part. You're on the roof.
Yeah.
You keep on climbing.
Wait, is there actually a stairway that goes up the roof?
You're in it. You're currently going up.
Oh, fuck. I wanted to climb up on the roof, not use the stairs. I was banking the suburbs didn't have a stairway going up. Oh well. Keep her going.
Well, the stairs are broken now, so we're fine.
Yeah.
You get on the way on the roof, and Gabe is sweating profusely. His wound isn't getting any better.
Well, we can't really just stop and, like, pat him on the back and make him better, so keep her going.
Yeah. Half the survivors along are scared shitless. They have no idea what the hell they're gonna do.
We don't have any alcohol to disinfect in the
Oh, we're up top, right?
Wait, you do have a health flask, if I'm not mistaken.
What does it contain?
That would be massive, because I don't remember picking it up.
Yeah, that would work. I poured on his wound.
Are we on the roof now?
You're on the wound, yes. Oh, you're on the roof, sorry.
Ah, nice.
On the wound, and it starts frothing white. It is agonizing, and his screams are just...
Called disinfecting with alcohol. Do we have a bandage to cover it up with?
You have a shirt.
No, that's...
Okay, yeah, he's right. I want to rip off a piece of... any form of cloth we have anywhere. Oh,
you roll a natural one. You are forced to use his loincloth.
Alright, you see an old American flag that is still blowing in the wind, and you quickly grab it down and tear it and just use it as a wound. As a bandage, I mean.
Most of the patriotic survivors look at you with disdain.
Look, whatever you can do. At this point, America is dead.
That's what you think, but according to Americans, he ain't. But I will.
Okay, so... give me a d6, Mattis.
Oh god. This is not gonna end well. Give me a sec.
You successfully wrap the flag around Gabe and tighten. Little do you know, you're tightening around his throat.
That's fine.
Oh, four.
Once you reach for the flag, you see a fire escape. There is a way to get back
down.
No,
it's a horde. A horde.
But they are inside, not outside.
Yeah, which means we're safe because the stairs are broken. It would take ages for them to form a fucking pile of bodies to climb up through. Mm-hmm. So for now, we're safe.
Yeah.
Gabe's like, I can still drive the bus, it's not a problem.
Go where though? The horde's gonna keep following us. Might as well just
it's
wait
not
it
gonna
out
follow.
Until they get bored.
If we manage to, and he takes out the thermal detonator, blow up the entrance.
Well then. I guess yeehaw, motherfuckers.
So you're going for the fire escape?
We're gonna have to, it's the only way down.
Yep. Okay, so you slowly start clambering down, and first thing you see are the fact that all the zombies are inside the building, and at the exit there's like two zombies that are just staring through the glass.
So the only way we're gonna manage this is if we drop the bomb in front of the exit and blow it up.
Yes.
Alright. Can I roll for accuracy to see how good I'm feeling for this fucking thing?
Sure.
How much? D6?
Yeah, it's a 6.
It was a 6. But then, you know.
I used to be a 6 like you, but now... Fuck! Just to use the dice roller, Zaxxon.
Yep, I'm on it. Give me a sec. While I just quickly tickle my anus. Okay, I should have the dice roller. Yep, it's in my bookmarks bar. D6, I rolled a 4.
Okay.
I feel a bit like gin today.
You chuck it and it is in front of the doorway. You're still in the fire escape, which is pretty close to the entrance.
Zach died.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Yep. Go on without me. I lost my internet rip. Oh.
Is it you know who?
Yeah, it's Zach.
No, I mean, not that. As in, is it because of you know who he lost his internet?
No, I think it just crashed.
Oh, rip. Yeah, it happened to me this afternoon.
You see an AFK symbol over his...
completely just shuts down.
Dun, 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 dun. Alright. Fuck it, the show must go on. You chuck it and you quickly start running towards the bus. The two zombies are clambering out. It's now or never. You're gonna blow up the thermal detonator?
Yep.
You quickly press it down. Give me a D6.
Alright, I forgot. She's not working. 6!
Okay. That changes the story that I wanted. You blow it up, no problem whatsoever, the bus is not damaged, and you're cave in the entrance. The zombies do start crawling out of the windows, but they're very slow, so Gabe quite literally just gets the fuck out of there, and you're off scot-free.
No, we left Scott behind!
Yeah, he died.
Oh, no! No, he owed me $20.
Fuck off. Matt, Adrian, if you please.
Yes. Okay. Yes.
Okay. The guy with the king comes up again in his black SUV, and he does not look happy.
Oh. Fuck's sake, is he gonna ask for more shit?
No. He goes up to you and he says, "One of your guys has been mangling with my shit."
I know nothing of this.
You know nothing
of
this.
What did they do?
We found some of our items destroyed outside the perimeter. None of our guys did it. We were on a raid last night.
Do I know who was missing that night?
Give me a d20.
Well, he was like not accounted for.
Give me a d20.
Hey.
Okay. You know that your daughter was not around?
Please, no.
Okay, fine. No, actually, no, I'm keeping the daughter. fuck off, this is my campaign.
Is it really my daughter, though? No, is it really my daughter, though?
You can try and interrogate her real quick.
I just want to ask her gently, like...
Give me a D6.
Hey there, little girl. Hey there. What have you been doing?
Okay, you do it in the most diplomatic way possible. And she bursts out crying. She admits that she had, in fact, broken the light that you had found, like the shards of glass, but she had never left that far out, and she has no idea where their camp is.
But what the fire, though?
The fire was caused via the glass.
Because of the... Okay, okay. That's okay. This is okay. I mentioned nothing to this to him, to the guy, because since it doesn't concern him in a way, it was our own.
Mm-hmm.
Was my daughter the only person that was missing?
There was also one of the survivors that you had picked up, the traveler. He was called Jeffrey.
Oh, Jeffrey, the engineer. Yeah.
Wait, is Jeffrey with? Wait, Jeffrey is with them. Fuck. Who's left in the camp except for you, the dog, and your wife and kid?
There was one random now. Wait, no, the random was with them
the
as well.
The random
right?
woman, the random woman of the guy.
Yeah, she
wasn't there.
She wasn't there.
No, you distinctly remember her not being within that particular place.
Okay. I ask her, like, I'm gonna connect the dots here. I'm gonna ask her if she's a previous, she was with them in the previous time.
No, we were not. We passed by them and they almost killed us.
So it's not ours, is it? Can I see if she's telling the truth or?
Sure, give me a d20.
Fuck.
You cannot sense.
Okay, I go back to.
He's just kicking his cane on the ground. He's like, "I'm waiting."
I'm gonna go out to the guy and I said, "Everyone here is honest. I know that everyone here is honest, and none of them seem to be." I asked her what was she doing like when she was gone anyway.
I was just searching around the perimeter. And you can see like a bead of sweat rolling down her face.
Searching on the perimeter for what? I already did the direct.
I was searching. You know, she's like sweating profusely now. Or he's just gonna keep on going. Hey, are you having a stroke?
They offer her as a virgin sacrifice.
Okay, how are you gonna offer? Open the gate and chuck her, or chuck her from the tower?
No, like, because since I it seems obvious that I know her. Does she just admit?
No, she's just sweating profusely. She looks guiltier than Christ.
At this point, I'm pretty sure, like, you're telling me, okay, yeah, this is the person.
Yep.
Okay. I said, okay, hey, why don't we take a walk outside? Let me just for some fresh air, because you seem to be sweating a lot. Okay, with me.
I'd rather not, if you don't mind. She's like slowly backing away towards a knife on a table.
No. I grab her arm just before she does that.
You grab her arm. She's like, no. She's trying to squirm, and she's yelling for help.
For
shut up! She's yelling out for herbs. Tasman, cumin, garlic. Wait, that's not a herb. Fuck.
There was my wife. Like, they're the only people, so I would think they would support my decision, even though they don't know what's happening.
Yeah. So you grab her, open the gate, and chuck her.
No, I grab her with a strong grip and just like. As if, like, it looks like I'm holding her in a friendly way, like, over the shoulder arm thingy. I'm gripping her like steel, and just like, hey, what's this guy's name again? The king?
Never give you a name.
Okay, I'm just like going up to him. Hey, I think I found a culprit here. She was missing that one day. She was missing last night. I'm very, very sorry, by the way.
It's not
a
problem.
You can have your way with her. You can have your way with her.
With a lightning-like reflex, her head is now rolling on the ground.
Oh man, you could have at least had some fun, like, you know, maybe just a bit of torture or something.
Not
very even. Sorry, by the way.
It's fine, she'll do a good supplement for the food she stole. And he takes her corpse and chucks it in the back of the car.
Alright then.
It's so, like, I'm sorry to bother you. Eats. Make sure none of these fuckers ever come by, because your head will be next.
No, it's fine. It's just my family here, and it's like,
we know
they're I'm the dominant one here. Like, if anything happens, I will.
That's why you let her out of your sight.
Excuse me, I was whipping my wife.
Fuck.
Foreplay.
Shut up. He gets into his car and he's driving away. Any questions?
Not really.
Okay, to the other chat. Oh, Zach is back.
Yeah. Hey.
This will be like, oh, that thing has caught fire.
We're back.
Hey, guys.
Yep. Hello. I'm back.
Okay, what music is this? Shitty. And will I get fogged over because copyright?
This is awesome. I have no idea.
No, it's fine. Think. Okay, so...
And technically, suppose if I remember correctly... You won't get fucked over because of what you may call it if you don't play the entire song.
Yeah, hopefully. Okay, so this is you riding back, and it's around 6 now. You had to have some delays as the bus was having some problems.
I have the plague.
Oh, shut up.
Nice.
I actually am legit catching cold.
Oh, you want me to put your penis in your butt?
Yeah, sure.
It is around 6, and you can see people actually at the back entrance waiting. They knew you were doing it. They heard the explosion from far away, and they knew something had happened. They saw the bus missing and the 40 people gone. And
oh, no, it wasn't us, sure. They must have been partying.
And they just
really loud party crackers.
If you let me finish my fucking sentence.
Nope.
You're riding in.
No!
Fuck's sake.
Mathis, come on.
We only have 10 more minutes.
Yeah.
Exactly, go.
As you're slowly riding back in, you can see Eduardo there with his walking cane, and he's looking extremely upset.
That's the worst thing you could ever get in the zombie apocalypse. Not a bullet to the head, not getting bitten by a zombie, but the condemning stare.
The rest are all cheering. The rest are all cheering.
Ooh, nice.
They know what you've done in a nutshell, and so some of them begin to cry. They've lost loved ones, they've lost family members, realize that only 20 have come back from this raid.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. RIP. Oh well.
Gabe goes out and goes up to Eduardo, and you can clearly hear him yelling, I believe this town belongs to us now. Welcome to the martial law.
Feels bad.
What?
This was basically his way to gain power in the village, was by doing this. The main is now under...
Oh, this is Gabe talking.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
This was his agenda all along. He wanted to take over Maine and give it a martial law.
It's not that
bad. I shoot him in the head.
Okay, give me a d20, Jesus.
Wait, I don't know if Gabe's the good guy or the bad guy.
Martial law isn't that bad.
Martial law is just like a police state.
Exactly. Yeah. It's not that bad, depending on how the soldiers treat the people.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, then I don't shoot him in the head.
You're like about it, and you're like, nah.
No. He's about to, but fun. I put my hand on his shoulder, like, do you know what martial law is? And he's like, no.
And then you just take out the projector, and it's
exactly.
Please note, I used to sell guns illegally. I don't really give a fuck about the law. He says, well,
I'm a police officer. I'm like, so martial law is basically when there's a bunch of police officers controlling the blah, 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 blah.
5 hours later. No.
The horde has taken over the settlement.
They close up behind, and there are like a few zombies on the perimeter, but they're not getting through. Thank God for heavily fortified metal. Eduardo takes the walk of shame back to his hut. He has been defeated.
Rip. Oh well.
The founder of the town you're currently in after the war is now under Gabe's hand, along with the 20 survivors that you have brought back.
Okay.
Some of the people are happy because of this. You can see others that are scared.
Where is Gabe? Have we just been following Gabe this whole time?
Yes.
And just listening to all this? So, I'm going to ignore something. Are you going to run this place now?
With an iron fist, if anyone's caught doing things out of line, they're going to have to respond to me.
Well, good thing you have big hands then.
I just hope he doesn't fuck the place up, otherwise we'll have to kill him.
Now, I know you have friends on the outside. If you want, the helicopter's probably fixed. Go for him, pick him up, and bring him back.
We have our own settlement.
We just came to see how this place is doing. Like, we didn't really have plans to come stay.
If you want to bring him, it's your choice. If you want to go back, we won't hold you. But we'll be
appreciate the offer. Could you give us a second to like talk about it privately?
He turns away and says, sure, but just remember about your girl.
Oh, cheers, man.
Oh yeah, we have to go back to her.
Ominous things. Sure. I'm gonna go over to Max's character, is it James, or?
No, I was...
No, you weren't James, that's Adrian. You were...
Lamberg or Charles?
Lamberg.
I think... Lamberg. Yes, we're Lamberg. Were you? No, you were not Lamberg. Lamberg is your character from Space D&D.
Charles?
Probably Charles, because you had a box
down with name. Who the fuck here? Look, Matt, just call him Matt.
Alright, I'm Charles now.
Charles.
I decided to have a name change.
So, what do you want to do?
I would rather stick to our own settlement, to be quite honest.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
We started a place up, we should stick to it.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
Plus, not to mention, I don't trust these people, and we are living in a military base, which means we do have a lot more good shit.
Yeah, let's go get Mary and let's get off. Where's Stephen and Jeffrey?
Stephen and Jeffrey are still working on the helicopter.
Okay.
Let's get the girl first, and then Jeffrey calls to you guys. Hey guys, come here for a minute.
Sure thing, Jeff. What you found?
There is a large radio set there, and you do remember that back at camp there was one similar, and you remember the amount of decibels that you have set it to. It was always left on.
Oh shit.
It's a way to communicate back to camp.
Okay, that means we call up Adrian.
My pants. No, before we do that, let's go get the girl first, then.
You go get the girl, I'll try to talk about AIDS.
What if something goes south?
You have an AK-47.
Fuck, Steven, come with me just in case.
Stay, Steven. I'll try and communicate AIDS. Let the NPC die, if anything.
Alright, I'm going to go... I'm going to go find the girl.
Again, story splits once
again. Like a freshest place. Yeah.
Story splits. Mathis, please communicate with Adrian. Then we'll move over to Zach.
Adrian. Edge.
Yeah.
Coming in. Over. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? I repeat, can you hear me?
All you hear from the other side is...
Hello?
You don't know you have to be pressing the button, right?
Yeah,
is that your turn on?
To talk.
Yeah, to talk, but like the hearing is still like, you don't have to press to hear anything.
No, you can. You're constantly hearing. You have to press to respond.
No. It was actually like on, like I left it on the bed, and like just the weight of my body was.
It's not next to your bed. It's like in the middle of the compound.
Oh, I thought I had like
his bed in the middle of the compound.
Yeah. Sort of like
no.
That.
No.
Okay. So like I just. How is it exactly? How does this machine work exactly? Like, what is it exactly?
It's a very old-fashioned radio two-way.
And I love to point out that, like, over this casual conversation, there's, like, epic battle music. Like, hello, my friend. Da, da, da.
Okay. No, I just want to, like, sex in this. So, like, we were doing it in the radio station, and, like, I knock over the...
You knock it over and press the button.
I press the button. Like, I just lean. Fine. I just lean on the button.
You have one classy wife there, lad.
This was a great idea to leave this asshole taking care of the base. There could be a horde like, right now rampaging through. Yeah, this was a great idea.
In my defense, he could have gotten a one when throwing the bomb because Zach DC'd, so he couldn't do it.
Yeah. In his defense, he has a wife.
Yeah. Well, you know, I could have been fucking his wife.
Hey.
Okay. Can we get back to the campaign?
Yeah.
You hear the sound of a zip going up.
You hear like a wet sweep.
Is it? How is everything at the base going?
Oh yeah. It's going great. It's going.
Go.
Go at the back. Go at the back. It's going great.
There is at the back.
You guys know we're not actually
you
there, right?
You forgot to lock.
Well, yeah, I know. That's like she doesn't just so that she goes
Jesus
out of earshot.
Jesus Christ! The kid was watching.
Oh my god.
We know you're a couple, so it doesn't really fuck. I don't really give a fuck. As long as zombies.
God, the dog was watching all along.
It's fine. She'll get to learn faster when she's older.
Oh, she gonna fuck. There's no one around.
I'm here.
Once again, epic music.
Yeah, it's epic fuck music, dude.
And anyway, yeah,
who will she bang?
Fine, that's the next entertaining episode.
What do you read about this whole?
How is everything at the base actually going?
Do I just communicate everything that's happened?
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
Maybe like three hordes have passed. That random guy. Wait, who's the name of the random guy again? I forgot.
The black guy.
I don't know. You had a couple.
Not Jeffrey, no, the couple.
Oh, no, you had a woman that was left behind. Yeah.
What was
you just had a woman and your wife. I don't know what her name was.
Random not woman number
thing,
one.
Okay, what about the guy though? That
random man number two.
Fine. Random man number two's wife or friend, whatever.
Yeah.
I met a powerful friend. What's called friend.
Was he a wizard?
No, not really. No, I mean, basically, I was trading with. There was this random person who came up and traded. I traded some food for a lot of fuel.
Sorry to interrupt. What is the? You know, in Far Cry 4, there are those wandering merchants.
Yeah. No, he was.
Yeah, that guy.
No, he was using a truck.
Okay.
Basically, we traded fuel, and I gave him food. It turns out this guy was like trying to run away from his
ex.
Like no, his settlement, and he just stole the fuel actually.
Oh, okay.
And he needed the food. He needed food to like survive the getaway. So the leader of the settlement then came to us. And said, you know, this guy was like a deserter, and this is how we treat deserters. And he actually, like, he has a cane, by the way. He's like middle-aged guy, but he has a cane. he unsheathed the blade in his cane and just slit his throat.
Okay.
And said, I'm gonna need compensation, like just sweeten his titties or something.
okay.
Yeah, and basically sometimes he comes to visit, he collects a small tribute, and in the end he promised me a big reward. The random woman number one one day sabotaged their place because like while I was, you know, busy doing it with my wife,
for God's sake,
I couldn't hear her sleeping in the room next door. I didn't question it because I was kind of busy. And then it turns out, after interrogating her, she sabotaged their base because the guy came back. He's like, someone from your base fucked with our stuff. I interrogated the people. It turns out she was the one. I gave it to her. The dude cut her head off. And she's like, I'm really sorry. Said, no, it's fine. Like, her body is going to compensate for the food we lost. I'm like, wait, guys, eight people? And he just, like, went off. I'm like, okay, then.
Tough times.
Eight people. All right, then.
Tough times, tough decisions, you know. Yeah. I'd do it. Without the fucking zombie apocalypse.
Why was I not present for this conversation, goddammit?
This is also, we survived, like, three hordes or something.
That's pretty good.
Okay, yeah, no, we're up to date now.
Right.
Over the radio, you start hearing.
Technically speaking, my character isn't.
Over the radio, you start hearing. Hello, main 502. This is Nighthawk. Hello, main 502. This is Nighthawk. Can you read?
What the actual hell?
I choose to keep listening in.
One of the engineers quickly picks up the radio and is like, Nighthawk, this is main 502. Where's your location? Now, story split. Zach, other chat, please.
Oh, sure.
Wait, what?
Okay, remember that you went to see your child.
We can call it level.
As you go in, you see that the curtains are drawn. Like, the doorway somewhat can't be visible from the outside, if you get my drift, but you don't pay any attention to this.
Okay.
You go straight through. Upon going in, Jeffrey gets knocked out. And there
is... go straight through when the door is open?
No, it's like a curtain, dude. It's a curtain.
This is Fersh's house we're talking about.
What?
This is Fersh's house we're talking about.
No, he already moved her out to the tent.
Oh, he moved her to the tent? Okay, sure.
You don't really pay attention, but you can't see what's going on from the outside. If any spectators are by, they will not see what's going on the inside. First thing off,
Jeffrey just walked in and got knocked out.
Yeah, and there is
Gabe. I've clearly seen this.
Yes, and Gabe is holding a gun pointed directly at your chest, and he's holding a lip to his mouth. Okay, what was his voice?
It was like a redneck as hell. Redneck as hell.
Alright, listen here. I like you people. Now you're gonna do what I say. Or the kid's gonna get it. What is your reaction to this?
No, that's not my reaction. Shit. I'm like, okay, can you lower the gun so we can talk like civilized people?
I think I'll leave it to make sure. You listen to me, and you listen well. We're going to send a helicopter to bring your people and what little resources you have. They're going to come here.
I have no idea what Mattis and Adrian were talking about, right?
On your way, you kind of heard him talk to Adrian. So you know they have communication.
I know everything. I know that they have communication?
Yeah, do you only know they have communication?
Okay. Sure. Do you know how to fly a helicopter?
One of our engineers know. He'll take you. You make sure they come back. If not, let's just say the kid's gonna have more things to worry about.
Okay.
Trust me, it's better this way. We are the new elite, and we will take over this land and get rid of the pestilence.
Alrighty.
Alright. Also, I'm keeping Jeffrey here just to make sure as well. You as much as Squeal, and both of them are dead.
Come on, man. Jeffrey's been loyal to you. He's fixed up the helicopter.
Tough shit. I've got to make sure.
Fair enough.
Anyways, you go by the child's side, and she seems to be getting better. The color on her face is back, and the wound is slowly patching up.
Oh, that's good.
Shit does not look good. This is...
No, I just have another murdering asshole to deal with.
The thing is,
once again,
he is not joking. Again, ex-marine. These fuckers do not fuck around. Move to the other chat so we can end the DND session.
Okay.
Okay, we're back.
Welcome back.
Mathis is BRB. Shit. Alright, yep. So... I hope you guys enjoyed. We're going to end the stream here for today. So, yeah, we're ending up off with perhaps you guys are going to go back, or perhaps you are going to send a helicopter
plot twist.
For them back.
So many plot twists. Storm energy was low to stream. Again, I am catching a cold. So,
guys, I have to go have a shower before tomorrow.
Yeah, we're stopping the stream.
Stream's over. Stream's ending.
Rip.
Alright. See you, lads.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.
See ya.
See ya.
Bye-bye.